Hi everyone, it's Lindy Yan from Pink Whisper Designs. Today we're going to create this really fun spring tulips frame card. I'm going to show you how to create a frame using some of your solid dies. We're also going to use a new set of stamps, the Easter Tulip set from Art Impressions, as well as several other stamp sets and dies from the Art Impressions collection. So let's go ahead and get started. So the first image we're going to be working with is this front and back sitting dog, and you can see that you get the front of the dog and the back of the dog. So if you want to create a window card, this is perfect for that, and it also comes with the coordinating dies. So we're just going to grab the front of the dog and we're going to go ahead and stamp that using some Versafine Onyx black ink, and I've got some Strathmore Bristol smooth cardstock in my mini misty stamp positioner. And I'm just pressing that out using my Stampendable stamp press. Now for colors, I'm using light pink, beige, and mid-brown. And all of the colors I'm using today will be listed in the upper left-hand corner as we're going along. And these are the Zig Clean Color Real Brush Pens. And these are a water-based pen. And I'm using the Zig Blender Pen to do my blending. You can see I added a little pink to the cheeks and then a little pink in the ear, and then I'm adding the beige and the mid-brown at the same time, and then I'm just going to blend those together, and I'm just adding the mid-brown where those shadows would be. We'll be using quite a few more images from Art Impressions today, so I've got everything listed and linked down below as well as on my blog. And for the tummy area, I'm just going to use that beige color, and I'll just blend that in just so it goes lighter towards the front of the tummy. And then, of course, we have the coordinating die, so we can easily die cut this. I'm going to tape this down with a little bit of Post-it tape. This is just a temporary tape that will hold this in place. And we'll run this through the Sizzix Sidekick machine. So once we have that die cut, let's go ahead and take a look at another brand new stamp set from Art Impressions. And this is called the Small Easter Tulip Set. And you can see it has this little backing on it. You can just remove that. And then it will be a repositionable stamp, and it also comes with these cute little charms, the little cross and a little heart as well. So I've placed that back in my mini misty. I've got some Strathmore Bristol smooth cardstock again, and I'm going to take out this little mat because you can see that this stamp is quite thick. So I'm going to remove that little mat from the misty, and then let's go ahead and ink this up again with that Versafine Onyx black ink. This is a permanent black ink. I'm using light green, green, and I'll use a little bit of yellow to do some highlighting on the leaves. And I colored in several of these. I think I colored in maybe 8 or 9 of these. I was just sitting and coloring. I wasn't exactly sure when I started coloring these, what I was going to be doing with them. So, and my creativity wasn't really on track this particular day when I colored these in, and I thought I'm just going to sit and color until something kind of strikes me as what I would like to do with this. So again, I colored way more than I needed, and here's where I came in with that yellow and just added a little highlight to those. And now I've got lilac and deep red grape. And I'm going to start with the lilac, add that deep red grape, and then just use my blender pen to blend those together, keeping the tops of the flowers the lightest. And since this set doesn't come with the coordinating dies, we're going to use some detail scissors, and we'll go ahead and cut these out. And there you can see I'm just removing a little bit of ink. If there was too much on there, you can grab that ink and pull it off your cardstock and scribble it onto your scrap paper. Now I've got the Wink of Stella clear glitter pen, and I'm going to just add a little bit of sparkle to each of these. And then we can set those aside to dry. You can see that there. So once yours are dry, I'm going to just start quickly cutting this so you can see what I did next. I'm just going to cut these out and leave a little white border around the edges. And there you can see all the ones that I worked on. So I've got plenty for other cards as well. And there's a closer look at that. Now let's take the birds and bugs set from Art Impressions. And you can see you get some bees, which we're going to be using today, three birds, a couple of little ladybugs, and a couple of butterflies. So let's stamp all three of these bees, and then I'm going to stamp a couple more. And I've got haze blue for the wings, yellow and bright yellow for the body. That haze blue is just going to give a little shadow to those wings. And then let's grab the coordinating dies, which this is what I love about this little set. You do get these dies. These would be a little bit tedious to cut out, so I can just run those through the Sizzix Sidekick machine. And now we've got all of these little bees. And I'm going back to that wink of Stella, and I'll add a little bit of that to each of the wings. Next, we're going to use the Decorative Journal Page 1. And we're going to be using that really pretty frame. And you do get a couple other nice dies in this set. One is to create a journal page. But I decided I wanted this to be a frame. And since it wasn't, I was going to turn this into a frame. So I went to my nested rectangle dies and I found the one that fits perfectly inside there. It's just a little bit short, so I'm going to show you how to fix that. So let's tape this down to some Strathmore Bristol Smooth cardstock, and I'm going to slide this die around so that I have an equal distance on the top, left, and bottom. And then I'm going to tape that down, and you can see that it doesn't go all the way across, but we're going to fix that. So I'm taping this down really well. I'm going to run that through the Spellbinder's Platinum 6 die cutting machine. And then all we need to do is slide this rectangle die over to the right a little bit. So we're going to make sure we line it up. It's kind of going to lock into place. I'm just going to slide it over. And now we'll have an equal distance on the top, bottom, and on the right-hand side of the die. And then I'm going to tape that down. And again, you'll kind of feel that lock right into place. I'm just checking that there. Tape it down really well, and then we'll run that through again. And that's going to give us a really pretty frame. So if your dies aren't frames, this is a really easy way to turn them into one. Now I've got my Spellbinder's tool in one, and I'm just using that to kind of brush away any of those excess little bits that are stuck in there. Now let's go to this set of dies. I'm grabbing that second largest one, and these are the Rectangle A2 Double Stitch dies from Art Impressions. And I've got this beautiful Easter Season 2 paper pack. This is brand new. And look at all these beautiful patterns you get in this set. We're going to be using that yellow and white stripe, and then also the pink and white gingham plaid. It's kind of a lavender and white gingham plaid. So let's go ahead and run this through the die cutting machine. And then I'm also going to run this through with the Strathmore Bristol Smooth cardstock just to thicken this up a little bit. We're going to layer these two pieces together. So I've got some Nuvo Deluxe adhesive. Let's go ahead and glue these two together. And then I've got that frame, and I'm going to go ahead and attach that. I'm going to center this on the front of this panel. And I did put plenty of glue all the way around. I put some kind of in between those little openings as well. Then I just used my finger to kind of make sure I had glue everywhere. And then again, I can center this on the front of the card. Now I want to create that opening right out of this center as well. So the striped cardstock and the Strathmore Bristol Smooth cardstock were just to thicken this up a little bit, because we're going to create a frame that you can see through to the scene that we're creating. So I am going to run this through a couple of times. Because we do have two layers of thickness of the cardstock, I'm going to run it through twice. And then we have to do that same thing again. We're going to slide it over. We're going to lock it right into place with that opening that we already created. And then I'm going to run that through. And again, a couple of times just to make sure I cut completely through both pieces of cardstock. And now we have this beautiful frame. So I'm just using my adhesive eraser to remove any of that excess adhesive from the post-it tape. And you want to be gentle when you do this, just kind of lightly remove any of that adhesive. And now I've got two more pieces of cardstock from this same pattern paper. That kind of lavender and white gingham, and then that really pretty blue and white swirly cardstock. So let's take the largest die from this same set and that second largest die again, and we're going to go ahead and cut these out. So that pretty swirly paper will be the same size as the yellow and white striped paper, and it will show through from behind our little seam. So I've got some 3D foam tape. I'm going to add that all the way around the back of this frame. And now let's grab a sentiment, the mini birthday sentiment set. And this has some cute little sentiments. We're going to use the one that says, "It's your special day." And I'm just laying that frame over top just so I can see exactly where that sentiment needs to go. And then we can go ahead and stamp that. I'm just straightening it out a little bit. I'm using the grid lines on the Misty just to make sure that that was nice and straight. And now we can go ahead and stamp that. I did stamp it a couple of times. When I'm stamping a sentiment, I like to stamp very lightly at first. And then if I need to add more ink, I can do that. Let's create a standard A2 size card. So this cardstock measures 5.5 by 8.5. And I'm going to score that at 4.25. So let's go ahead and glue down this gingham plaid. And that will fit perfectly on the front of our card and give us that nice stitch border around the edges. And now we can add this blue swirl paper. Again, we're just centering that. And then our frame is going to go there. But first, let's tuck some of these little tulips inside the frame. Now I'll glue a few of these flat and then I'm going to pop up every other one. So I just needed 4 for the front of the card. I'm going to glue this down. I'm just using that frame just to make sure I have everything placed where I want it to be. And then I've got the small adhesive squares from scrapbook.com. I'm going to add a few around the back. I'm using my Cricut weeding tool just to pull those backings right off. It just makes it really quick and easy to do that. Now this one I'll glue flat again. I did have to lift that up a little bit just so I could tuck that in behind the one that I popped up. And then let's add this last one by popping this one up as well. I did have to be careful about the tape that will be sort of to the right-hand side of the frame because we already have some foam mounting tape there. So I did end up removing a couple of those little foam squares and added some glue just so it would lay nice and flat behind there. And I was debating about having some of them stick out the front of the frame, but I changed my mind. So I'm just going to have everything behind that frame. Now I'm using that Cricut weaving tool again to remove the backing from the 3D foam tape. And then we can lay that right over this blue swirly paper. Now let's take our little pup. And we're going to put them on the front of the frame, just overlapping that frame just a little bit. And then I glued that down, but I did decide to add a couple little foam squares in underneath him so that he would not get bent in transit. I just wanted him to, you know, pop up nicely there. So I'm just going to add a couple little foam squares behind him. Now I've got the little bees, and we're going to be adding three of those to the front of the card. I also wanted to finish off the inside of the card, so I'm going to save one for the inside. And let's go ahead and glue this one down. I'll have it kind of overlapping that frame a little bit. And I put the one on the flower there. You can see one is on that little tulip. Now I've got the bookmark die set from Art Impressions, and you can see it creates this really cute little bookmark, but it has some little extra dies in there, and it has this little heart. So I'm going to just grab this. Any heart will do. Any heart you have in your collection would be fine. I'm going to use the center part of this heart. It does die cut the frame and the center, but all we need is that center piece. I die cut it once from that gingham paper, and then once from the Strathmore Bristol Smooth cardstock, just to layer this up to make it a little bit thicker. And then when you die cut this little puppy, there's a little notch it creates under his paws. So you can slide anything you want up under there. You could put a sentiment there or some little flowers there, whatever you want. So I just held that in place until it was completely dry. And then I decided to add a few little stitch marks around that heart. And I'm using my Pitt Artist pen. This is the 0.1 millimeter black pen. Now let's go to the inside of the card, and I'm going to create this little mini envelope. That's the die there. And this set contains several really cute dies. And this is the journal template die set. And so I went ahead and die cut that out of that same gingham paper. And I'm going to add a little bit of glue just so we can close up this envelope. And then let's go ahead and stamp a sentiment on there. So back to that same stamp set, I'm going to grab the sentiment that says cheers. And this is a very bold sentiment. Even though it's tiny, it's very bold. So I'm just prepping that stamp with my fingers before I ink it up. And to do that, you just want to rub your fingers along that stamp and take off any film or anything that might be on there. It'll just give you a nice clean stamping. So I went ahead and stamped that, and then let's go ahead and grab another one of the little tulips and glue that into our envelope. And I think I've told you in the last couple of videos, I'm really kind of into finishing off the insides of my cards lately. Just think it gives it a nice look. And then it's ready to go. When you need a card, you have one that's all ready and all set to go. So let's go ahead and pop that down in the center. And then I'm going to grab a couple more of these bees. I thought I only used one, but I think I did use two. I'm going to put one on one of these little tulips as well. We can save that other one for another project. And here's what I had left. So like I said, I got a little carried away with the coloring. So let's use these Shimmerz. These are like little stars that come in the Buttons Galore and More set. I put a few on the front right around that little puppy just to make him look sparkly. And then I'm going to add three on the inside of the card. And again, all the products I used today are listed and linked down below and also on my blog. So let's take a look at the finished card. And this is just a fun little frame that you can create using any of your dies that you have. And here's the inside of the card. So I really hope you enjoyed today's video. If you did, please hit the like button and subscribe. And don't forget to hit that notification bell so that you don't miss a single video. Thanks so much for joining me today. I hope you all have a great day. Take care. Bye-bye.